These three software are currently the most famous 3D programs in interior design, and they feature three completely different extrude systems, starting with the simplest software, SketchUp. SketchUp has a very intuitive and simple operating system, so even with many limitations, it's extremely popular. Its most important function is push, which is essentially the extrude in other software. The main technical core is the ability to automatically merge and delete faces when pushed all the way to the bottom, allowing quick creation of holes in various shapes. However, SketchUp's push function has quite a few restrictions, such as can't push multiple faces, auto merge and split, and can only push along normal, among others. Therefore, SketchUp is an excellent choice for beginners in 3D, but for complex models, it requires extensions to assist. Blender. Blender is my favorite among all the software I've used. It's free, open source, and incredibly powerful. Blender's extrude function is more comprehensive and has fewer limitations compared to SketchUp, but it requires a higher learning curve. Basically, all extrude features are available in Blender, except it's missing SketchUp's core function of automatically merging and deleting faces. This means extra steps are needed when creating a hole. Blender has tried to address this by introducing Extrude Manifold, but it's still clumsier and less intuitive than SketchUp's push. So, is there an extrude software that's both intuitive and fully featured? 3ds Max. 3ds Max is a powerful software where all operations are highly counterintuitive. But what's special is that it has the most intuitive and advanced extrude system. It includes all the extrude modes that Blender has, plus Smart Extrude. When I first saw Smart Extrude, I was blown away. It's incredibly powerful. Smart Extrude allows extrusion on different faces for addition and subtraction, and it can weld into another entity, enabling quick creation of various surfaces and complex models. However, Smart Extrude still has its own limitations, such as inability to extrude along normal, exact length, or extrude individual. Now that we know the differences in extrude among these three software programs, and if we were to rate the extrude functions of these three software, I would say 3ds Max is undoubtedly first, followed by Blender, and lastly SketchUp. The purpose of making this video isn't to complain about Blender's features, but to improve its shortcomings in this area. After discovering 3ds Max's Smart Extrude, I've been searching for similar functions and add-ons in Blender, and finally I found the closest one, the Punch add-on. Not only does it require payment, but it also has functional deficiencies. In the end, I decided to develop Smart Extrude myself. Finally, I finished the add-on. My Smart Extrude is quite powerful, and it's built based on Blender's operational logic, so there's no extra learning cost. More importantly, it's completely free. The usage is very simple. Just press Ctrl plus Shift plus E, and the interface is in the Modify panel, where you can see the extrude length, other functions, and their shortcuts. In the default operation, it's extrude along normal. You can control the length by moving the mouse up and down. If needed, press D to extrude unevenly. You can see that it is perfectly extruded. Press O for extrude individual. Additionally, you can input numbers for exact control of the length. Note that the unit is meters. And after pressing B, you can extrude based on the length of the face near the mouse. If it's not the length you want, you can zoom in to ensure it's that specific face's length. And press Alt to enable the operation mode like 3ds Max's Smart Extrude, allowing free movement of the extrude position. You can press Shift plus X or Y or Z to move along the other two axes. You can also use Blender's built-in align function. Press Ctrl to align, or press B for point-to-point operation. The flip function can reverse the extrude face. And I've also added a preview function, which comes in handy for special cases. If you're excited about downloading my Smart Extrude add-on for Blender, once downloaded, open Blender, go to Edit, greater than Preferences, greater than Add-ons, and click Install. Navigate to the ZIP file you just downloaded and select it. Check the box to enable it, and you're all set. I hope this add-on can help you. Thanks for watching.